Hello everyone, Mr. H again, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will be learning how to graph linear inequalities. Let's take a look at example number one. So here, the given inequality is y greater than or equal to 5x plus 2. So if we take a look at the given inequality, the inequality is already arranged in the form of y equals to mx plus b. So if you remember graphing linear equations using slope and y-intercept, so we will be applying the same concept here. However, for inequality, there will be an additional step in which we need to shade a specific region on the graph to identify where the solutions are located. So going back to the given inequality, so since it's already arranged in the form of y equals mx plus b, so we can identify here the slope, which is 5, and the y-intercept, which is plus 2. Now, if you remember how to graph linear equations using the slope and the y-intercept, we start with locating the y-intercept. So this is positive 2. This is actually from the y-intercept, which is 0, 2. That's going to be the very first point that we need to plot. Now, to find the other points, we need to apply here the slope, the rise over the run. So applying the rise over the run is actually counting the units on the grid. And we will start counting the units from the y-intercept, which is our first point. Now, so we're looking at two options here. So either we go up 5 times or 5 units from the y-intercept and we go 1 right. So 5 up and 1 to the right. Or we can also go down 5 units, then go 1 unit to the left. So we count 5 units up first. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we turn 1 to the right. So this is our next point. From the y-intercept again, so we're going to go 5 units down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1 to the left. 1. So this is our next point. The additional thing or the additional step that we need to do in graphing linear inequalities is actually the shading part. Since the symbol is greater than or equal to, definitely the line must be a solid line or a bold line. And the second thing is the shading. So you need to identify which region you are shading. Are you shading this part right here, which is, we can say, on the left side of the straight line? Or are you shading this part right here, which is on the right side of the straight line? Now, in order for us to know which region or area needs to be shaded, you have two options. The first option is by just looking at the given inequality symbol. Now, since the given inequality symbol here is greater than, that means that we are shading the area that is above the line. That is the first option. The second option is you can choose what we call a test point. So mostly the test point we use is the origin or 0, 0. Then after choosing the test point, you can simply substitute the test point to the given inequality. And after substituting, if you got a true statement, definitely you're shading the region where the test point is located. On the contrary, if applying the test point to the given inequality and it gave you a false statement, what you need to do is to shade where the test point is not located. So we chose the origin as the test point. And the given inequality is y greater than or equal to 5x plus 2. So applying the test point to the given inequality, it's going to give us 0 greater than or equal to 5 times 0 plus 2. So 0 greater than or equal to 2. Is this statement correct? Absolutely not. So applying the test point or substituting the test point to the given inequality actually gave us a false statement, because 0 is never bigger than 2. So since it gave us a false statement, definitely what we need to shade is the opposite. I meant the area where the test point is not located, which is hand side. So this is what we're shading. Now, what does this mean? Basically, the region that's shaded is where you can find all the solutions to the given inequality. And since the line here is a solid line, all the points that lie on the line itself are also included in the solution. Given the inequality, 3x minus 2y is less than 10. Now, if you notice that example B is not arranged yet into slope-intercept form. So what we need to do is to simply arrange first. So it's going to be negative 2y less than negative 3x plus 10. So divide the inequality by negative 2. So it's going to give us y greater than 3 over 2x minus 5. Now, the inequality, you notice that the inequality symbol flipped from being less than and now it's greater than. Now, if you remember the rule for inequality, whenever you divide or multiply the inequality by a negative coefficient, definitely the inequality symbol should flip to the opposite. So this is now our inequality where we will be basing our graph from. So we have the y-intercept. The first point is negative 5. And this is the y-intercept here. Sorry, that's too big. So negative 5. And the slope of this line is 3 over 2. So that means that we're going up 3 units from the y-intercept and turning 2 units to the right. So we count 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. This is the next point. Then we can repeat the process. 1, 2, 3 up, and then 2 to the left. 2 to the right, rather. Look at the inequality symbol. The inequality symbol here is less than. So definitely we need to adjust or change our line, because since the inequality symbol is less than, the line must be dotted line or broken line. All right. This is also, now from less than, it became greater than. After the symbol flipped from less than to greater than, definitely we are shading the area above the line. So we're shading the area above the line because the symbol flipped to greater than. So double check by choosing a test point, like what we did in example A. Now, another thing is, since the line here is a dotted or broken line, definitely the points that lie on this broken line are not part of the solution set for this inequality. That's another thing to take note of. Okay, and for the last example, so for the last example, we are given a system of linearly applying the same process here, but since we are given two inequalities, we need to graph them, or we're given a system, we need to graph them on one grid, and there's a bit of a difference when you identify the solution region, or the region where the solutions are for a given system. So let's take a look at and graph it first. So the first inequality is x less than or equal to negative 4. For the first inequality, since the only variable is x, we are expecting here a vertical line graph. And the symbol is less than or equal to, it tells us one thing, that the line is a solid line. So negative 4, so this is x is equal to negative 4, so it's a vertical line. And which area are we shading? Are we shading the left hand or the left side of the line or the right side? You are correct. So we are shading the left side because this is where we can find all the values that are less than or equal to negative 4. Since it's a solid line, definitely all the points that lie on this line are part of the solution set. Line, we have y is greater than 1. Now, since the second inequality gives us a y variable only, then we're expecting a horizontal line. Since the symbol of inequality is greater than only, definitely the horizontal line must be a broken or dotted line. So we're shading the one of the area above the horizontal line. So I'm going to be using a different color here. Okay, actually the graph of y greater than 1. And remember, since the line is a dotted or broken line, definitely all the points that lie on this line are not part of the solution for this for the second inequality. Now, after graphing both inequalities, you notice that the shaded regions actually overlapped. And where did they overlap? They systems of inequalities, after graphing, including the shading of the correct regions, the overlapping shaded regions are where the solutions are. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching.